Hello and welcome to CNN News 18 special broadcast. This is Komolika Sengupta. Today, when the center claims that the entire development process is in a look east way, then, you know, a couple of days we are seeing that there has been a deliberate attempt of disturbing Northeast, and specifically last Saturday, the incident which took place in Manipur, where a commanding officer was ambushed, attacked by the militants, his family and other soldiers died there. This incident again puts a question that is there a deliberate attempt of destabilizing Northeast? Today, we are going to discuss on that, and today we are joined by the Honorable Chief Minister of Manipur and the development face of Manipur, Mr. N. Biren Singh, who is really working hard for the development of this area. Welcome, Mr. N. Biren Singh, Honorable N. Biren Singh, to our show. And thanks that, you know, you have given us time. First question, obviously, would like to ask you that right now, what is the situation of that area, the Churchudda Pur, where the ambush took place? There's constant homing operation going on. You were saying that day. What's the situation right there?
Thank you, Kamalika Sengupta. You have given me a chance to say something. You know, that was very unfortunate accident. I, on behalf of the government of Manipur and as well as representing this people of the state, strongly condemn the ambush, which was killed, including one lady and one small child. And that was, you know, Manipur is bordering with Myanmar, around 390 kilometers unguarded borders, the forest border, you know. So because of this militant, they're taking their advantage for such things. But in the last 4.5 years, after my comments comes, this type of incident never happened. Exactly. But suddenly, I'm also surprised there might be some vested interested instigation because the election is coming. Hardly within 2-3 months, our general election will be held. So just these people are trying to destabilize and create panic to the people who is believe in the democracy. I take so. So, but I'll not allow to happen. Eat and I'll not succumb. That area is now already sensitized, and paramilitary forces and the civil commandos, police forces are combing at in and around the area to nab the perpetrators. And I'll try to deliver justice to the people.
Yeah, absolutely. As what you pointed out, that the elections are coming and there is a deliberate attempt. So do you think, as that day also you were saying after the incident, that obviously a very aggressive combing operation you are doing, do you think that there has been some instigation from across the border and what it is?
Some instigation from the vested interested group is there. As of now, I cannot say without any proof, but definitely instigation and with the instigation, they're trying to destabilize the peace loving people of the state. And they are very much zealous about the past 4.5 years we spent peacefully, harmoniously in the state.
Absolutely, as you pointed out, for the last five MSME sector, you have generated more than 1 lakh employment. And Mr. Modi has also, Honorable Prime Minister has also, you know, applauded you from Italy. From that point of view, how will you deal this situation from the security perspective and from the political perspective? Because people are panicked, you know, undoubtedly people are panicked. How will you handle both this situation, in what way?
No, you see, communicate in the within the state. Within the state means in the general place of the state is this nothing to do with this, you know, the threat. It is taking place in the border area, in the far border area of the with the Myanmar, the Behan, where thin population is settled there. And taking the advantage of the vast jungle. But here they cannot enter in the, inside the street, in this town or in the villages. And they are operating from the cross border, I can say, not operating from inside the state, inside the our boundary. And it will, nothing's happen in the general public.
So, you know, this, you know, this is one thing which is clear, that the general public of Manipur should be at, you know, they should feel at peace because things are not going out of hand. But, you know, attacking civilians, this was something very new. 2015, the last incident took place. After that, your government came, and really you have also put in so much of effort. Attacking civilians, some of the forces, people were saying that it's like a warlike situation when the civilians are attacked. What's your take on that?
No, civilian, you know, just, you know, I cannot elaborate much on it because Assam Rifles commandant were himself visiting the outposts, sacking the outposts in the border area. During that, his visit, that ambush was taken place. So I don't want to elaborate anything, but we definitely will defeat this type of terrorism act, and strong action initiated and will initiate.
And you already, you know, that day only you visited that area and you said that this 390 kilometer. Now, fencing is an issue. Have you spoken to the central government regarding the fencing issue? And what are really, you know, you're going to do about this fencing issue? Because that's a very porous area, right?
Yeah, just porous area, and you know, just we have identified along with the Union Home Ministry official the vulnerable area, and decided to fence at least 100 kilometers as of now. But out of 100 kilometers, the Home Ministry has already given go ahead for 40 kilometers, and now the fencing is on, but due to some land dispute, due to some land dispute in some area, it is holding. But Home Ministry people have already reached Imphal, and the fencing will continue. I can assure you.
Okay, so they have now reached Imphal, you know, after this incident, and now things will again start.
After this incident, but they have already here, BRO is already taking up the fencing, and we will fence those, the vulnerable area first.
How much of that is left, in the fencing is left, how much of that is left?
No, we have to, as of now, just around 100 kilometer vulnerable area identified, 40 kilometer has to be taken up. Now 10 kilometer is work is started now.
So that is one thing. So the fencing thing will also be sorted out, as you stated. And another important thing, you know, whatever things have been recovered from the place of occurrence, there, you know, the rifles and all, they have this Chinese link to it. So do you think, you were also saying that there is a border, obviously across the border there has been some instigation, but do you think that such obviously PLA is supported by the Chinese, so is there any threat on that perspective?
Well, you know, just where I am today, I am in the position, I cannot comment on that matter, but that will be dealt by the central government, home ministry. And for me, just I'm reporting, I am providing whatever information available to the authority.
Obviously, because this is very sensitive issue at the
Yeah,
same
yeah, yeah.
time. From there, another question comes up. You know, so much of, you know, we have so much of sports personalities coming up from your region, so much of employment generation. So do you think that this sudden incident is going to affect the election somewhere?
No, nothing to do with this. Nothing to do with this. As I pointed out earlier, this it was happening in just the border of the Myanmar, which is thinly populated jungles. So, and here they cannot enter and they cannot do anything here in the within the state in the public.
But there were like so many IEDs that were, you know, incorporated there. So do you think that intelligence a little, there should be a little more seriousness on the intelligence part, or, you know, something which actually happened which nobody knew?
Yeah, we are seriously reviewing the intelligence also, how it has was happened and why it was not notified or intelligently the route. So we're looking it into very seriously.
Very seriously. And another thing is that, you know, you are, you know, to this militant organization, which are dormant, last 5 years, there has been no report. And if we see the Parliamentary Standing Committee's reports also, the graph is going down. So, you know, is there, will you talk with them? Is there a chance of a dialogue, or the, no, head on with the, you know, the administration will go head on with them?
Yeah, just I, on behalf of the central government, invited them for talks, and some have given the positive response, and definitely let us see some positive sign is there you can do.
Okay, so that dialogue, you know, that call, when that has been given, before this attack or after?
Before this SSS, I am continuing my effort to bring them to the negotiating table, and I am trying my best.
Okay, but PLA has never, sir, they have never actually gone for any peace talks. Or what is your message to this organization who are trying to still, you know, still come alive, showing something or the other?
No, talk, table talk is the only solution. There will be no place of violent, and like our country, India. India is not a weak country, and India always believe in political solution and talk. And I think they have to come forward for talk and for a amicable settlement.
Sir, another thing which you rightly did for the last 5 years was strictly control of the drug movement and the, you know, the total this nexus. You actually curbed that also. Do you think that that is also another reason where it's a problem for them, and that's why there has been such attack?
You see, I am fully on war on drugs because Manipur's falls within the Golden Triangle also, and taking the advantage of the porous border with Myanmar, this type of smuggling things is taking place. It might be in some reason, but I cannot fully blame on it also, but enemy is increasing when I does this kind of operation against them and drugs and weapon mercenaries, illegal weapons and this kind of things. Somebody might have hurt.
Yeah, definitely. So, you know, that thing, there is no, you know, you will continue that one in one way, you know, ekdam strongly curbing the drug thing. The second thing is the operations will go on. You know, last time in 2015, we saw a sort of, you know, sort of cross-border, you know, they crossed it and there was a attack. So, do you this time also, is there any, you know, we can expect any cross-border movement? Though it is obviously a very sensitive issue and
Yeah, very sensitive issue that will take decision by the central government.
yeah, by the central government. But that thing, you know, to, after 2015, we have seen that it was they just there are a lot of times that such you know, the neighboring country Myanmar obviously has there been any talks with Myanmar after this attack with you regarding this?
No, from my level, not at all, but it might be taken up through the, External Affairs Ministry, and that might be taken up.
So, you know, that is what you, what do you think that that is very much required also for such because they come, they do something here and go back that side.
Very much require, and the instability in Myanmar, that also a problem, Instability in
But
Myanmar, there's also a problem.
do you think that, you know, the February the things have changed there also, and then, you know, this thing happens here in Manipur. So that is also an effect of what is happening.
Little time having little doubt of the situation in Myanmar, also a little be related.
That can be related, but still there is hope. And one thing I would like to ask you that, you know, you are reaching to the people, that you have started a program where if there is anybody's problem, they can call you. If there is an online problem of any children, that also we have seen that you have reacted. So how are you actually building up this man at, you know, civilians and administration contact, you know, about both of the program? What's the feedback of these two programs which you are having?
You see, Kamalika, in the democratic system, keeping touch with the grassroots people is very important. In my experience, involvement of grassroots people in administration, that is, very, very, very interesting and very effective. In the last 4.5 years, I started two, three schemes, go to hills, Parsalo. Matlab, there was a division between the valley and the hills.
CM Dahasi, there's
Then after that, and I started the go to village.
another.
Only all these things were launched to deliver the beneficiary schemes. What provided under the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji and what we, the state government, have to doorstep delivery. That result is amazing. In the recent 4.5 years, how Manipur had achieved so many things. So many things, And I have two, three programs more, the Miyam Vinumit, People's Darbar. Every 15th of every month, every 15th of every month, and every 10th of every month were Hill Leaders Day. I do meet them before the pandemic. But only through that I established relationship with the peoples, and everything has stopped. No ban, no blockade, nothing is there. Earlier Manipur was known as the land of state of blockade, ban.
State of
But after,
instability.
in a state of instability, disturbed state, troubled state. But after doing this, all these some schemes and a program, relationship between the government and the public has rebuilt and started gaining confidence by each other. And now, after the pandemic, I could not meet people frequently. Then I have started one schemes, CM, the high C. Let us say to CM, I provided telephone number to them, and they will call me and they will say, these are the grievances, these are the things. So, in the last 10 days, around 10,000 call comes.
But then on the other hand, I would like to just mention, Mamata Banerjee also has this program in Bengal called Didi Ke Bolo. And the Trinamool people have said that you have copied them. Is it true that you have copied them?
No, I see the Go to Village is I started in 2017. The recently Mamata Bengal started Ghar Ghar, kya bolta hai, Zalo?
Duare
Sarkar. To mere se imitate kiya hai, copy kiya hai. Or
Didi Ke Bolo, that she has started after 2019.
Haan, wahi to, but I started earlier. हम तो 17 से शुरू किया है ये सब तो दे आर कॉपिंग मी आई एम वेल हैप्पी कि एटलीस्ट इवन इवन कश्मीर में गो टू बैक टू विलेज यू नो और इवन द दिल्ली का स्कूल फगरन जी आई हैव स्टार्टेड इन द 2017 स्कूल फगरन जी लेट अस इंप्रूव स्कूल्स एंड वी हैव कवर्ड 60 स्कूल इन 60 असेंबली तो उसने दिल्ली में भी कॉपी किया है तो आई एम नाउ बिकमिंग द
पायलट हेल्प यू नो डज इट रियली हेल्प अ फुटबॉलर टू बीएसएफ टू अ जर्नलिस्ट एंड देन टू सिटिंग इन दिस चेयर डज दिस चेन रियली हेल्प इन एवरी वे
या रियली यू नो ड्यूरिंग माय स्पोर्ट्स करियर आई डू विजिट ऑल ओवर इंडिया ऑल ओवर इंडिया आई मेट आई टेस्टेड आई नो Then, being a journalist, you know, investigative journalism I was doing.
Okay, that's great.
So, everyone, even government, state
so
government.
So, you know what not to answer me, right? How not to answer me, right?
So, these are the few experience I had. And still, I'm learning. I'm learning lots. And I'm trying to do differently. You know,
coaching people from other parties. You know, lastly also you made joining and all. So there would like to ask that Manipur election is now 3 to 4 months away. How confident N. Viren Singh is to come back to power?
I am coming back. BJP with full majority is coming back to power with the blessing of Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. Nadaji, Amit Shah ji, this, you know, they're helping us, they're guiding us like anything. And I'm assured they will definitely come back in power with full majority.
But then obviously this incident and the stability things obviously will be an issue in the election, as you know. What promises N. Viren Singh gives to the people of Manipur and to the people of Northeast that this type of incidents will not happen?
Yeah, I can assure this type of accident will not happen and will not allow to happen because India is a big nation. India is a peace-loving nation. India is a democratic country, democratic system country. So if anyone come, want to say anything, it come to the tables. Otherwise, we are not going to succumb in the threatening and the force.
So that's, we can say that that gives the inference of, you know, the message to the militants is we will go head on, come what may. But if you want to talk, come for talks, you come. That's what the message which you want to give?
Yeah, just come to talk. Then otherwise, they have to face the consequence.
Yeah, so come to talk, otherwise you will have to face the consequence. That's what is coming from the top of the state, the Honorable Chief Minister. So there's no, the government will not succumb down in any way. On the other hand, you are batting for development. You'll be batting with the development, right?
Yes. I'll do my diplomatic works with the people of the state and I will achieve Manipur as a model state in all over the India. It is my dream, and the peace will be maintained, and I will not succumb to any kind of anti-India, anti-national activities. I will not.
How does another question before we, you know, just we end? How does it really feel when Narendra Modi, Honorable Prime Minister, applauds you from Italy? You know, with the MSME thing, he tweeted that day. What was the feel?
No, I am so fortunate, but in reality, it shows the concern Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji has for Manipur and its people. We always knew Manipur has a special place in his heart.
So that's this. And another thing is that we can end in that note that we will see Manipur as a better place, a developmental place without any instability. So there is like, you'll go head on, and but the dialogue road is still open, right?
Definitely, 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 Kamalika.
That was so nice talking to you. You have provided us so much of time, and it's your busy schedule. We'll definitely do more on Manipur, because that's what the place, the Northeast is the place, which is actually to be showcased to the entire India. And that was so nice talking to you. Thanks a lot, sir. We'll again meet.
Thank you. Thank you for putting so many sensitive questions to me.
That's what my job is, sir. And you are, because you're a former journalist, you know how to actually bat that ball out. That I can see it. That was very good.
Thank you. Namaskar.
Thanks a lot.
Namaste. Namaste. Namaste.